Warren asked whether or not AT richness has something to do with their function. So we looked through the genome and said, if we look at 1 kb sequences with AT composition that's similar to the sequences that do confer robustness, can we predict whether a genomic region will be robust or not robust? And we're able to do this, actually. We're able to predict 4 sequences, 2 from C. elegans and 2 from Drosophila melanogaster DNA, that have high or low AT content in terms of dinucleotide frequencies, and they function just as predicted. So based on these regions were selected for their dinucleotide composition alone, and they seem to behave the way that we would expect. So that gives us some confidence that whatever this AT richness does, that is what is causing the robustness. So why would AT richness be related to robustness of expression? Well, AT rich in general does not tend to be bound by the histone proteins that wrap DNA into chromatin. And the distal UNC47 promoter was determined not to be bound by histones by a genome-wide nucleosome positioning assay that was done by another group. So we're pretty confident that, at least in terms of its endogenous locus, you see here when elegans is expressed in Briggsy. And when you combine a strong cis with a strong trans, the breathing into elegance, you get strong expression. So the reason why that happens is because the divergent regulators are being brought together in a way that we infer, some means that some C. elegans factor is recognizing the motif in C. Briggsy sequence, and then activating the expression in these two cells where it should be activated. So of course we ask, what are the divergent cis and trans regulators that are causing this expression? So we figured that a transcription factor that would have this function would be expressed in the STQ cells, and it would also be expressed in some subset of the neurons that usually express 147, that endogenously express the gene. There was only one transcription factor protein that fit that description, and it's called AHR1. And then we crossed a C-Briggsy promoter GFP-containing strain into the mutant strain. We see that expression in STQR and STQL is completely abolished. So this makes us pretty confident that AHR1 is the transcription factor responsible for this ectopic expression. Fortunately for us, AHR1 has a known binding motif. And this binding motif is present in the proximal promoter. So when we take the C-Briggsy-M47 promoter and we express it in C. elegans, once again you see very strong expression in the STQ cells. And this is the cell DDB that's part of the endogenous pattern that also expresses. But when you knock out this particular binding site, you lose expression. So when you knock out the transcription factor, you lose expression in these cells. And when you knock out the binding site, you lose expression in these cells. And while you don't lose expression in DPD, the intensity of expression falls by about 100-fold. So it seems like this binding site is involved with regulating expression in DPD, which is part of the endogenous expression pattern. But as a byproduct, it can activate expression in the STQ cells. When you combine the binding, when you combine the C-Briggsy regulatory sequence with the CLA transcription factor environment. But here's the thing that really confused us. The binding site is completely conserved between Briggsy, Brenner, and RNAi and elegans. It's boxed in here, CACGC. So we next looked to nearby sequences that might differ among C. briggsy and the other species. And we have this region here that we call region A. It contained a good amount of divergence among these species. And so what we want to ask is, are the sequences from elegans and briggsy functionally equivalent, or are they different? And the way we're going to test them is by switching them back and forth. So we're going to take a briggsy promoter, and we're going to put that little region A of C. elegans into the middle of it. And then we're going to do the opposite experiment, take an elegans promoter and put a tiny piece of briggsy in the middle of that. And we're going to ask if they are functionally equivalent or if they do something different when they're swapped. So as it turns out, sequences in the C. briggsy region A and interactions with outside sequences are sufficient for expression in the STQ cells. So here we have the percentage of worms expressing in the cell STQR and STQL. And we have elegans over here, Briggsy over here, and then the two chimeras in the And you see whether you have a Briggsy region A or Briggsy outside of region A, you express just as strongly as C. briggsy. So it seems like there are at least two elements that are each sufficient for expression, one within and one without this, this region A. On the other hand, in STQL, Briggsy expresses strongly, elegans expresses very weakly, and both of the chimeras express very weakly as well. And so this suggests to us that there's an epistatic interaction between something in Briggsy region A and something outside of it.